Hello, good people. Welcome back to this amazing channel. To my returning subscribers, thank you so much for the support. If you are new to this channel, kindly subscribe for amazing videos. So today we have a new video and I'm going to show you guys how to prepare and cook fresh fish. So let's get into the video. Here I have some fresh fish. So we got this from home, just from the lakeside. So I normally use the thermos cooler box that I got from Carrefour to carry my fresh fish or other fresh products. So you just buy some ice cubes and then you use them to store whatever you're carrying. So that's where we normally carry our fish. So we got some tilapia and also a big Nile perch. So I have 3 pieces of tilapia and 1 big Nile perch. So I'm just going to prepare them and then we get into the cooking. First, when preparing fish, you have to remove the scales. The scales have to be removed before you can do any other thing. And this is so easy. I don't know why some people always fear doing this, but this is so easy. You make sure the scales are removed and also you remove the part that always covers the gills so that you can wash the gills and then they be clean. Empty hearts and neon lights. Once you remove that hard part, you see now it's easier for you to wash the gills and then you'll find that it's so bloody, so you have to remove that. Once you are done with the scales, you have to remove the intestines. So you see, that's where the intestine is. So you have to make sure all that content is taken out before you wash your fish. The tilapias were medium size, so I decided to slice them into 2 portions so that they can be easy to store and also fry. And just like that, the preparation of the first one is done. So we continue with these other ones and then we move on to the next part. You can see how the Nile perch is big. So my partner decided to assist me in doing this because portioning the Nile perch is quite difficult. So he really came in handy and helped me with this. Then within no time, everything was done and we were ready to do other things. Cutting the Nile perch into pieces requires some good energy, I tell you. With this, I would have suffered this if I was alone.
Silver, no more heartbreaks, tears, painkillers. Take me somewhere unfamiliar. Bring me back to where we started.
finally, we are done with the preparation. So I'm just salting them so that I can let them dry. You have to salt the fish that you're going to fry so that they can have some taste after frying. But for the ones that you're just going to make fresh, you don't need to do this. So that's what I'm doing here. Now they are ready. Let's go, let them dry. I just put them to dry on one of my grilling pieces, and my partner decided to make the fresh fish as I cleared the sink, and this made work so easier within no time. We were done. You can see the fish that you're going to cook. This is how he prepares fresh fish. This is also another way of preparing fresh fish. So we are doing tilapia, just two pieces for this night. Cooking fresh fish is always so easy. You just have to cook your onions. When they're golden brown, add the tomatoes, a pinch of salt. If you want to add your spices, you can do that at this time. But with us, we didn't add spices for this one. So once the mixture is well cooked, just add some water, dip in your fish, and then just let it cook. When the only thing you'll need to add for the fresh fish is more water as it reduces until you feel that like it's now ready and well done. Maybe after two additions, it will be ready. So the fish is just beginning to cook. Preparing some managu also on the other side. Get me out of broken hearts and starting fights. Turning truth to lies. Gotta get up, stop wasting time. Yeah, I wanna run off and fly. These have also dried, so I'm just going to get into the deep frying process. It feels like home. Make sure the oil is fully heated so that they don't stick onto the pan, and then they come out so good, you know. I hate all this overthinking. Look at that. Second addition of water. You can see our fish is now ready, so we're just about to have our dinner. I also made some kales on that other side. Deep frying also done. Everything looks yummy here. Also made some extra veg. Welcome for dinner, y'all. So this how my dinner looked, so delicious. So this is ghee, the traditional one, not the one that people get from the supermarket. So that's what you use for kienyeji mboga. So let me enjoy my dinner, guys. Until the next one, bye.